So our next property is electron affinity. The amount of energy released when an atom in the gaseous state accepts an electron to form anion. Now this property is basically for non-metals. Non-metals, to become stable, they gain electron. So they accept electrons. And then atom has to release certain amount of energy, and then it gains electron, and finally it becomes stable and forms anion. Now here, to understand that, let us consider a neutral atom, say chlorine. Chlorine electronic configuration is 2, 8, 7. Now this neutral atom of chlorine is in need of one electron to become stable. So it has to release certain amount of energy to become stable. So it will gain one electron, it becomes anion and releases certain amount of energy. So energy is released. And it becomes stable, anion. So here neutral atom is becoming anion. Electron affinity, the word affinity itself explains us the attraction for electron. So affinity is nothing but attraction. And who gains electron? So non-metal gains electron. And non-metal, when they gain electron, always they become anion. Why? Because here the number of electrons are more than protons. So they become anion. Now the factors which are affecting electron affinity are: smaller the atom, greater is the electron affinity. Now to understand this, let us take the example of sodium, an alkali metal, and chlorine, a halogen. Now in this third period, if you move across the period, in the third period we'll see that sodium, being the largest, has to release very less amount of energy, and it will not gain electron. As it is metal, it has to lose electron. So sodium being largest, the electron affinity is very less, and chlorine being the smallest in the period will need to release more energy. So smaller the atom, greater is the electron affinity. Or in other words, you can say smaller the atom, the force of attraction is more, so it will have more attraction towards the electron and it has to release more energy. Second is, electron affinity increases with an increase in nuclear charge. Now to understand this, let us take the example of oxygen and fluorine. Oxygen has 8 protons and fluorine has 9 protons. Both of them are in second period. So across the period, the number of protons are increasing by 1. As atomic number is increasing, number of proton increases. And you will see that oxygen has 8 protons and fluorine has 9 protons. See, here the more the protons, more is the electron affinity. Means the force of attraction is more, so electron affinity is more. Here the amount of energy this fluorine has to release more in comparison to oxygen to gain electron. Now electron affinity of elements having completely filled and less than half filled orbital is practically zero. Now to understand this, let us take the example of third period elements, sodium, whose electronic configuration is 2, 8, 1, then magnesium 2, 8, 2, and aluminium 2, 8, 3. Here silicon 2, 8, 4, Then here we have phosphorus 285, sulfur 286, and chlorine 287, and argon is having 288. So these are the electronic configuration of third period elements. You will see that the elements which are less than half filled orbitals, less than half means half is always the valence electron will never be more than 8, 1, 2, 8 valence electron. So less than half filled means these are sodium, magnesium and aluminum. Because they are metal, they will not gain electron. So their electron affinity will be zero. And completely filled orbital, their electron affinity will be zero because it is already stable, it's not going to gain electron. So here, less than half filled orbitals, these three, and completely filled orbital will always have zero electron affinity, zero. So these are the three factors which explains us the electron affinity. So what is electron affinity? The amount of energy released when an atom in the gaseous state accepts an electron to form an ion. Thank you.